Hi, this is me, Mehreen Kaiser, and topic of my presentation is the contemporary Pakistani women's movement and dilemma of the Pakistani society. Firstly, I will discuss abstract of the present research paper. The objective of present research was to assess the content of placards used in women's march in Pakistan and analyze it with feminist perspective. Qualitative research method was used to conduct present research, and content analysis technique has been used to analyze the content of placards used previously in the women's march. Feminist movement is facing many challenges in the Pakistan, and present article is an effort to address such issues regarding patriarchy and discrimination against women from the perspective of Islamic feminism, which dares to challenge patriarchal mindset and discriminatory practices against women both in private and public sphere of life. The Aurat Women March is an annually held socio-political demonstration on the International Women's Day in Pakistan, has given birth to the contemporary women's movement in Pakistani society. Firstly, it was held in year 2018 in Karachi, which is a metropolitan city of Pakistan. After organization of successful event in year 2018, it was extended to other cities of Pakistan, for instance, including Lahore, Multan, Faisalabad, Larkana, and Hyderabad. In year 2021, the women marches were held in Karachi, Lahore, Islamabad, and other cities of Pakistan, despite harsh criticism from the right-wing people of the society. Current feminist movement all over the world falls into the category of fourth wave of feminism. Clear example of fourth wave feminism is Me Too movement, especially in the Western countries. In Pakistan, the 8th March is celebrated as a day to celebrate womanhood, and since 2018, Women March is kind of a socio-political demonstration held in various mega cities of the Pakistan. Representation of women's image in popular culture in Pakistani society is quite outdated, and those women who dare to speak about women's issues and gender equality are often demonized in Pakistani society by the people who adhere specifically to the right-wing's ideology. Mostly, Women's Day purpose is to give tribute to women who have done something meaningful and extraordinary in their lives. However, there is sort of misogyny in Pakistan, and due to patriarchal structure of society, women are considered inferior in the intellect. Women is a custodian of fathers, brothers, and husband's honor, whereas men are the main providers for women's maintenance, so women are not expected to step outside the home. Women can't just be a woman having their own identity. She has to be someone's wife, daughter, sister, and mother. Image of ideal women prescribes that women should stay at home and shouldn't participate in economic and cultural activities. No society can flourish without women's economic, social, and political empowerment. In societies where women are treated unfairly, there is exploitation for them that leads to imbalance in the society. Gender-neutral roles of both genders should be promoted for the promotion of gender equality worldwide. So now I will discuss the salient features of contemporary Pakistani movement. Few men are also participating in women's march, which is a good sign and show solidarity with women. This thing is different from the Western form of feminism in Asian context, where men are allies of the women. Second, the main feature of the contemporary Pakistani women's movement is that they are raising genuine issues. In South Asia, women are facing issues regarding education, health, decent employment, security, justice, and poverty, and there are a lot of issues faced by Pakistani women, but the main focus is emphasized on public sphere of life. There is need to address issues from the private sphere of life. Third important feature of the contemporary women's movement is that there's sort of a backlash against feminism and women's movement. There's sort of backlash against women's movement since 2018, when Women March was started, because issues of private sphere of life were discussed in broad daylight in the form of organized protests. Someone who dares to talk about women's issue is labeled as working on the foreign agenda. In popular culture, especially in media, women are reprimanded for being vocal on feminist issues. So now I will discuss the objectives of my research. My first objective was to find out the placards used in Women's March, and the second objective of my research was to do gender analysis of placards. Now I will discuss a literature review part of my article. I have used basically two books regarding feminism and state feminism. So first book which I have consulted for the review of literature is by Farida Shahid, and her title of book is Two Steps Forward and One Step Backward, which was written in 1987, and she has raised the issue that since the establishment of Pakistan, people from the right-wing ideology have tried to control women's mobility and tried to impose restrictions on women. Second book which I have consulted for the literature review part is by Helga Mary Hernes, and she has basically discussed the concept of state feminism in her writings. So there is also importance of state feminism in Pakistan because it will definitely improve women's situation. If we look at the Chinese feminism, mostly feminism is state feminism. So there is a need to promote state feminism in Pakistan so that the women's issue can be addressed at state level. And at state level, women's education, health and employment issues should be addressed by the government. It must be ensured that at state level to address the issues pertaining to private sphere of life, to address issues of domestic violence. There is importance of raising narrative of middle class Pakistani women. When it comes to the theoretical framework of my research, I have employed Islamic feminism. Islamic feminism is a major form of feminism emerged in 1990s in response to Western feminism. In present article, I have analyzed women's movement in Pakistan from the perspective of Islamic feminism. Islamic feminists are of the view that there is need to address issue of patriarchy and misogynist interpretation of the religion. And Islamic feminism basically tries to address gender inequality in both private and public sphere of life. Now I will discuss the method part of my research. So basically, I have employed content analysis technique to analyze the play card used in Pakistan on Aurat March. These images were downloaded from the open access resources available on the Humsub website. So permission was not required from the participants of the Women's March. So content analysis technique is a basically research technique used to make replicable and valid inferences by interpreting and coding textual material, but systematically evaluating text, for instance, documents, oral communication, and graphics. So qualitative data can be converted into quantitative data, but here in my research, I have used images to draw conclusion based on the analysis of play cards. Okay, so now I will discuss the findings of my research. In South Asia, women are facing issues regarding education, health and decent employment, and security and justice and poverty. There are a lot of issues faced by Pakistani women, but main focus is emphasized on public sphere of life. There is need to address issues from the private sphere of life. Despite controversial slogans and misuse of feminism by fundamentalists in Pakistani society, many positive messages were conveyed through placards in the annual demonstration held on 8th March in Pakistan. So the first image which is present in my article is about the women's education, and in this image you can see the issue which is raised by feminist is that my daughter will get education and will excel in her life. And if we talk about the second image which is present in my research is about domestic violence law should be passed. So third image, if you look at this, this is about girls want protection from the harassment. So harassment is a main issue which we can say is present in even Pakistani society, and it needs to be addressed, and a lot of measures have been taken in the last few years to address the issue of harassment. If we look at the fourth image, it is about that women are against war and they want to promote peace in the world. If we talk about fifth image, it's about the concept of consent, and the girl who is holding this image is basically saying that don't find consent with my rejection. So this is the also main issue which women have to face both in private and public sphere of life, that their consent is not mainly sought for many reasons, and women are now raising their voice against this kind of discrimination against them. If you look at the figure number 6, which is about divorced and but happy, shows the acceptance of divorced women in Pakistani society. If you look at the image number 7, this is quite interesting image, because in this image it is written that I don't know where your socks are, and this image basically is depicting the situation which women face in their private sphere of life, and mostly married women have to face this issue because their husbands are very careless and they expect their women to find their personal stuff. So this is very interesting image. Okay, if I talk about the figure number 8, it's very very interesting because it's depicting that not all feminists are men hater, because usually feminism is the concept which is associated with the Western society. But in the situation is that in fact, if we talk about the Islamic feminism concept, this concept of feminism is not alien to many Muslim countries, because religion has provided us with sufficient rights, but it's due to cultural practices that women are usually denied from their rights. So if we look at the figure number 9, again, this is also about the concept of consent, that girl is saying the chant rosary of consent every day. So if we talk about the figure number 10, it's about the women's important position in society, and the basically guy is holding this image is saying that women has come, now who will save a pervert. So it's basically describing the situation that now women are aware of their rights. So if we talk about the image number 11, it's about that women want their share in the property, and they're saying that they shouldn't be provided dowry when it comes to marriage, rather than they should be given their share in inheritance. So if you talk about figure number 12, so you can see it's about that women are saying that suspect someone else's daughter, sister and mother, because women are very noble creatures of God and they should be treated with respect and care. Okay, so if we talk about figure number 13, it's about that a girl is holding its image and saying that I'm a mother, sister and not an abuse, because this is images depicting the situation that how abuses are hurled against women. Even men are fighting with each other, they would use these kind of abuses in which they try to insult the opponent's mother, wife and sister and daughter. So this is sort of very important message. Okay, so if we talk about figure number 14, it's about the feel the anger, because usually women are expected to suppress their emotions and they are not expected to be vocal about their rights. Okay, if we talk about figure number 15, it's in this image you can see a girl is holding an play card in which it said that your gaze is bad and I'm expected to wear veil. So she is trying to say that nobody can force women to wear any specific dress code. So another important message you can see in the figure number 16, and it's about that I'm not a lollipop who needs wrapper. So again, she is trying to say that women shouldn't be forced to wear a specific kind of dress code. So if we talk about figure number 17, it's about dark and doubly with reference to dark skin color, because in Asian societies white color is given preference. Figure number 18 is very important, and it carries important message that I can change the tide of God, and it's obviously challenges the traditional gender division of labor. So if we talk about figure number 19, it is very important that a girl is saying that today all women are uniting despite their class differences. So figure number 20 is very important. In this image you can see that women are aware of the fact that they are expecting resistance from the society. Okay, so if we talk about figure number 21, it mentioned that it's not crime being a woman, and figure number 22 is about the positive messages about future of women's movement. And if we talk about figure number 23, it's about again the concept of dowry, and women should become a woman of substance. And figure number 24 is also interesting, because in this image you can see a guy is holding an image and he's saying, tell your weeping sisters that not all men are alike. So basically men are also allies of feminist movements in Pakistan. Figure number 25 is about the consent issue, and it's not a consent if it makes me afraid to say no. So it's another important message. If you talk about figure number 26, so this girl is saying that don't worry about my marriage, rather than you should be worried about my independence. So you can see these messages are very positive in nature. Figure number 27 is about that women is holding a play card, and she's saying that girls just want to have fundamental rights and women should not be killed in the name of honor. And if we talk about figure number 28, it's about say to no to the dowry concept and say yes to inheritance share. If we talk about figure number 29, it's highlighting the important fact that how male ego is important with reference to the feminist movement in Pakistan, because usually women are discouraged to participate in these kind of events because male ego is hurt by their family members. Okay, so last image is about interesting concept that arranged marriages, not marriages. So they are trying to say that women should be given even a freedom to choose their life partner. So if we talk about the conclusion of this present research, I would like to say that Pakistani women are working hard with limited resources, and women development is closely linked with the development of healthy family and society, which eventually leads to the development of country. So fortunately, there is exploitation of women in the name of religion and misogynistic interpretation of religion, although there is some improvement in the status of women in Pakistani society. So that's all for my presentation. Thank you so much for patience hearing.